Welcome to the Circle of the Panda podcast. It's your host, J.D. Ross. And this episode is going to be about what Circle the Panda is all about, because I often get asked that question. And this is going to hit on the underlying intentions of this podcast. So I think it's time we answer it. Now, if you're listening to this in a progression or you're going back and binge listening, you're going to see a bit of a pause in this. And that's where we're pausing to get some changes made to make this even better. So let me answer that question. What is Circle the Panda? Circle the Panda is a business incubator. Now, when people ask me that question, I normally get three responses. One, sometimes it's, oh, yeah, I get it. Sometimes they go, I'm not sure exactly what that is. Or sometimes they pretend like they get it and they have no clue. They just want me to quit talking because they're like, okay, that's all I want to know. No more explanation. So I'm going to explain it on here because there's a lot of value in what we're accomplishing. And it goes back to our belief. And I'm going to say belief, but I'm going to say it's more than belief. It's what we know. And that is this. Business is a platform to have a very positive influence on the world around us. Sounds like a touchy-feely, huggy type, whatever term you want to use, right? But business has the obligation. Notice I changed the language here. Business has the obligation to have a positive impact on the world around us, in the communities we serve, the customers, the people that work for us. Now, it's not always clear how positive looks, right? There's some hard things you have to do. There's some customers you have to say no to. There's some people that you can't hire. There's some people you have to have those hard conversations with and let them go or separate or stop the business interest. Those are also opportunities to learn and grow for both sides, which will be another topic of a podcast episode. But we believe that when intentionally, with intentions, when a business does things with the right intentions, let me put it that way, you can have a very good impact on the community around you. So let me describe the community that we have typically a heart for, or we serve more often, and why we serve that group. Well, you're going to hear throughout this that we tend to gravitate towards special needs, neurodiverse, disabled, or there's people that are often overlooked because they sound different, act different, and sometimes think differently. Now, if you think through that is, there's a lot of people in that group. And it also goes into age, which I'm going to hit in a minute about age. But if you look at that group, okay, I'm going to talk about it, one, from a little bit of a compassion standpoint, but it's not about compassion. There's also a degree of just being pragmatic from a business standpoint in that. So I'm going to hit those two and then go into the podcast intentions and what you can hear. So from a compassion standpoint, this goes back to, we are obligated to help those that are in need. Those that are in need now you can't have dumb compassion and start just giving stuff away. I've tried that. You're going to hear that in an episode soon coming up. You can't just give out things because then you kind of err into, you can in proper settings, but you've got to be very careful about how you do that, or you start enabling. So it's not that. It is going, there are some that are genuinely in need. How can we assist those? Either in just saying, we're going to help you, or we're going to help you get yourself out of that, however that looks. So there's a bit of that in this. Secondly, when you're in those situations, there is a bit of magic that shows up when you just give without the intentions of getting something back. There is a bit of magic in that. And then from the more pragmatic standpoint, we were all created. Every single one of us was created in a perfect image. We all have some kind of talent, some kind of something we can give, even if it's just this warm smile, the ability to do something that makes a difference. We have that. It's a matter of finding it. And if you can find it with the right kind of support group around you, then what are the possibilities? What are the possibilities? So if you're looking from a business standpoint, you're saying, I'm going to start a business or I'm going to help somebody with their business, whatever that looks like, whatever degree that Circle the Panda is involved in a business setting, when we go, we're going to do those things and we're going to look for people that are often overlooked because they're going to be grateful, they're going to do a great job, and they have a skill set that, with the right kind of support, can do extremely well in business. So that's the pragmatic part about some of the groups that we serve. Now let me shift into something here. Because when I describe look different, sound different, act different, I'm not just, that's a broad category. And those that know me, or those are going to get to know me, I'm going to kind of set this up. I don't always look the same, act the same, or think like everybody else. So it's kind of a broad group. And listen, on this journey, let's face it, I am 57. I am 57, and we, this group at Circle of Panda, is chasing a dream. We are chasing not a dream, we're chasing dreams. At an age where often people will say, we're just going to write them off. It's time to think about sitting on the couch and eating Cheetos. It's time to just move on because this is a time of life when some people have the most value because they have created the wisdom that have take that has been years of failing and succeeding. So you're going to hear that. You're going to hear on this journey a lot about failure, a lot about succeeding, a lot about people's individual journeys as they've tried to say, I'm chasing a dream that is inspired by someone larger than myself. You're going to hear that tone throughout these podcasts. And why are we doing this? Because we want a listener. Even if it's just one listener, and the listener base is growing. It's our third podcast, the listener base is growing. If we have one listener that hears this and go, wait, I can do that. I'm going to learn from their mistakes. I'm going to learn from what they've done well, and I can do that. All we want, all it takes is one single listener to do that. And I was reminded of this yesterday when I was meeting with a friend of mine. And I've always been somewhat soft-spoken. Now, those that are just meeting me in the past couple of years are going, wait, hang on a second. Soft-spoken? What are you talking about? We'll get into that in an episode a little later on, actually with a tattoo I have on my wrist and what that means. But typically, I've been very soft-spoken. But I was thinking about it last night about a friend of mine that's trying to sort out how to transition out of a situation where he thinks it's a dead end. And he wants to transition to something that just gives him joy, gives him happiness, makes him feel fulfilled. And I was sitting there going, hang on a second. Where I have typically not given a lot of information about myself or my own personal journey, I'm looking, going, the best way I can help is to say, you know what? I'm going to just tell you information about where I've failed, where I've fallen just flat on my face. There's a reason why we go through hardships. There's a reason why we go through hardships. And that is because we can turn around and help others going through a similar situation. It's orchestrated. Things are orchestrated for you. If you've been through a hardship, if you've had a difficult time, go, there might be a reason. Some of the reason is because you made your own choices. And they turned out poorly. In that, if you turn back around and say, okay, either this happened to me or I made these choices and these things that happened to me. Now I'm going to find a way to turn back around and help somebody that's at a similar sit in a similar situation. So that is why this podcast is being produced. Through the failures, you're going to hear the stories that might help you. Through successes, you're going to hear stories that might help you. But in the end, or not but in the end, and in the end, we are all about pursuing dreams. They are possible. They are very possible. In the end, they may not look like you thought they were. They may be even better than you even could have imagined. And in pursuing them, we're also saying, if you're pursuing them, or when you're pursuing them, I'm just going to assume that you all are, because that's what our hopes are, is that, again, one person Only takes one listener to go, wait, I have something. With the right kind of support around you, with the right kind of wisdom, to succeed and set the example. Base it on something that's going to have a positive impact to those around you. So that is what Circle of Panda is. I'm going to describe in future episodes how it got started. Again, the journey that we're on, the dreams that we're chasing, the people we engaged with that have helped, the people we've just called up and said, we're curious about what you are doing. Will you please talk to us? So you can hear some guests coming out through that. And we're excited for what the future holds. And if you need anything at all, reach out to me at jd@circleofthepanda.com. With this, I wish you all the best and peace to you.